Hi everyone, welcome to a new video series for Korg Arranger keyboards. This is about the sound mode, which is used for creating new sounds and editing existing sounds. This is a big topic, so there will be multiple videos on it. This is the first video, and in this I will cover some basics of the sound mode, how a sound is structured, and an overview of the editing options in the sound mode. I will try to make it as simple as possible here. I'll create more videos specific to each of these settings in detail. Let's start with the topic now. The sounds on the keyboards are generated by the sound engine, which is a synthesizer. It generates sounds using several methods. There are different types of synthesizers based on the sound generation method they use, like the FM synthesizer, sample-based synthesizer, additive, subtractive synthesizer, etc. The sound engine on the PA series keyboards uses multiple synthesis methods for sound generation. Basically, it is a sample-based synthesizer which uses sample files as a source of sound. It also uses different tools like filters, envelope, etc. to modify the sound from the samples. Filters use a subtractive synthesis technique. It removes some frequencies from the original sample. You can layer up to 24 oscillators together in a single sound. This is an additive synthesis technique. To make it simple, the keyboard uses samples as a source of sound, and it uses some tools to modify the sound before it goes to the output. In a sample-based synthesis, there will be pre-recorded audio files in the memory of the synthesizer, and those will be used to generate sounds. A sample usually is a recording of a single note from a specific instrument. The synthesizer uses this file and transposes the original pitch while different keys are pressed on the keyboard. This produces different notes on the keyboard for that instrument sound. There would be different sample files used to generate a single instrument sound. Let's now look at the structure of sounds in Korg PA Arranger keyboards. There are two types of sounds on the keyboard: normal sound and the drum kit. Drum kit has different samples assigned to each of the keys. The normal sound uses multi-samples, which is a collection of sample files split across different keyboard ranges. I'll explain more about the multi-samples later in this video. If you look at a normal sound on the keyboard, at the top level we have keyboard sets or performances, which contain three upper tracks and one lower track. Each of those tracks contains one sound. So the keyboard set or performance is a collection of sounds layered in tracks. If you go into sound assigned to one of the tracks, we can see the sub-elements inside it. We can view it in the sound edit mode. We can go to the sound edit mode by pressing the sound button. If you need to edit a specific sound from one of the keyboard upper tracks or style tracks, select that track, then press shift and the sound button together. The sound in the current selected track will be opened in the sound edit mode. Here we can see oscillators inside the sound. There will be one or more oscillators in it. In a synthesizer, oscillator is used to generate sound. Here in the sample-based synthesizer, oscillator is used to play the sample assigned to it. In a sound, we can have up to 24 oscillators, which means 24 samples can be played together in a sound. They will be layered like tracks playing together. So when you play a sound, you would be hearing sound from multiple oscillators. All the oscillators can play in parallel, or they can be set to play on specific trigger events like velocity range or key range or some other triggering modes. Each oscillator can contain one or two samples in it. If there are two samples assigned to one oscillator, they both can be set to play in different velocity ranges. Velocity is the pressure applied to the key while playing. So you can set to play different samples based on the pressure you apply on the key. The sample assigned to the oscillator is called a multi-sample. This is a collection of audio files which are split across different ranges on the keyboard. So when you play a sound, it will be several audio files playing together. The polyphony of the keyboard depends on the number of oscillators used at a time. It uses one polyphony per oscillator. Now let's check the sample structure. When a sample is used to generate a sound, it is transposed to different pitches by the synthesizer based on the key pressed. Normally, a sample would be a single note of an instrument, like this sandoor sound. This has one sample file used here. So when we press the other keys, the original sound is transposed to the new keys so that we will hear the sounds in the note we pressed. But when the pitch is transposed from the original sample, there would be a range of keys which works better without any quality loss. So to avoid quality loss on the keys at higher distances from the original sample's pitch, additional samples with a higher or lower pitch are used in that key range. So the quality loss can be avoided. This piano sound uses multiple sample files for different key ranges. So having multiple sample files increases the quality of the sound. When we arrange the sample files with this key range assignment, it is called a multi-sample. There can be one or more sample files included in it. This multi-sample will be the input of the oscillator in the sound. So this is the structure of the sounds. Multiple samples together form a multi-sample, which goes into an oscillator. One or more of such oscillators together form a sound. They are added to the keyboard sets for style or song tracks. The drum sound has another structure. Instead of multi-samples, each sample is directly assigned to a key and that forms a drum kit. I'll create a detailed video on the drum kits later. The samples assigned to the oscillators are not just played as it is in the sample file. There are many options to change the way they sound. This is achieved by the different components in the synthesizer like filter, envelopes, LFO, etc. I'll give a quick overview of the options in the sound mode. There will be detailed videos on each of these later. This is the main screen of the sound edit mode. Here we can set some parameters for the whole sound like the ADSR envelope, filter cutoff, LFO settings, effects, etc. Now, if you press the menu, you will get some more options for sound editing. The basic section. This is for setting the oscillators, assign samples, set the trigger mode, velocity and key ranges, EQ settings, etc. You can adjust these settings for each oscillator. This is a pitch tab. This is used to control how pitch change happens for the sound. The pitch change can happen on different events, key press, controller triggers, etc. Just to show an example, the pitch slope can be used to set the pitch change rate. Default value is 1, which means 1 semitone incremented on the next key. This is how it sounds if I play a chromatic scale. If I set it to 2, this is how it will sound. This is applied to each oscillator separately. The other oscillator has the value as 1, so there are 2 different types of pitch changes now. Let me solo the oscillator. Now we can hear only one oscillator. If I set it to -1, the pitch will get reduced when moving up. This is a filter. It is used to shape the tone. It will remove specific frequencies of the sound before giving it to the output. The frequencies below or above or in between specific cutoff points are removed using the filter. Here we have 2 types of filters, low pass and high pass. Low pass allows the frequencies below the cutoff range to pass through, and it removes the frequencies above the cutoff point. High pass allows the frequencies above the cutoff point and removes those below the cutoff point. The cutoff and resonance knobs are the filter controls. I'll explain it in detail in another video. This is the amp section. It mainly controls the volume of the oscillator. You can use it to control the pan and touch sensitivity as well. This is LFO. It means low frequency oscillator. There are two LFOs available in the keyboard for each oscillator. Unlike the normal oscillators, LFOs will not produce any audible sound since they are in low frequencies. They are used as control signals using which we can modify the sound. They generate signals with a cyclical effect in a specific shape. We can select different waveforms for each oscillator, which generate a different shape of pulse or sweep. I'll demonstrate this later in this video. This is for the FX settings. Unlike the other traps, this is applied to the entire sound. You can select the master effects and insert effects for the sound from here. Using these settings, you can modify the output of the sound. You can control the changes to the sound over a time using different control options. This is done using the AMS or the alternate modulation source. Most of the parameters in the editing section we saw now, like the filter, pitch, amplitude, etc., can be set to a fixed value, or they can be set to keep varying based on the modulation source selected. By using the AMS, we can choose different sources to trigger the parameter changes at runtime instead of applying the entire value altogether. Let me show you with some examples. Here in the amp section, the pan can be controlled using an AMS. There are two settings while applying AMS, the intensity and the source or AMS. Here I am setting a higher value in the intensity. Now in the AMS, I am selecting LFO1. This is the LFO1 selected for the oscillator from the LFO page. We saw that the LFO is used as a control signal. It creates a circular effect in a specific waveform. Now this is changing the pan in a circular motion. If we select a different waveform for the LFO1, there will be difference in the way the change happens to the pan. I'm setting the AMS to the channel aftertouch. Now, only when I use the aftertouch, the pan change happens. I'm changing it to joystick Y+. This is when I move the joystick forward. Let me show you one more AMS setting. Going to the modulation tab. Here for the velocity intensity, I'm applying an AMS. I'm setting it to joystick Y+. Removing the pan from the joystick. Increasing the intensity. Now while playing, if I move the joystick forward, the volume will increase. So that is AMS. And this is just an overview of the sound mode. I'll cover each of these settings in detail in other videos. So that's it for now. See you in the next video. Thank you.